I'm Simon Graber, for those of you who haven't seen my other talk yesterday. So I work as an LTSP developer and Ubuntu liaison at Revolution Linux. I'm also an Ubuntu core developer, and the presentation will be on keeping in touch with Ubuntu, so that all upstream projects can actually sort of help the Ubuntu project. And so we get really stable release of your software. So the presentation is split that way. We start with, in order to understand how Ubuntu actually works for the development, the easiest is to look at the release, our release schedule and release cycle. Then I speak a bit about where you can actually find Ubuntu developers and users if you want to speak and see what they can provide you. Then speaking about main tools, which is Launchpad, and can also be used by many other projects. And then, Ubuntu Brainstorm. I guess some of you haven't actually used this one, or maybe even don't know about it. So, just a quick presentation. And other resources you can use to see what's happening in Ubuntu. And finally, how you can help any questions. So, to start, let's have a look at the release cycle. So, as most of you probably know, Ubuntu is releasing every 6 months. We have long-term support release every 2 years, usually. Until now, it's all we do. That may change. Usual support is for 18 months. Long-term releases are 3 years on the desktop, 5 years on the servers. So that's for the release. The way Ubuntu is developed is that just after a release, we actually start working on specification for the next release. That usually happens during a month. Then we all meet together at the Ubuntu Developer Summit. Next one will be in Barcelona in 2 weeks, or 2 or 3 weeks. During the Developer Summit, we discuss these specifications, establish blueprints that we publish on Launchpad and on the wiki. After that, we'll come back home and actually try to implement all these specifications. Usually, only half of it, or something like that, is actually implemented because we don't have as many manpower as we would like to have. During the development cycle for release, we have 6 alpha release, then 1 beta, 1 release candidate, and finally the final release. During the first 4 months of release cycle, anyone with upload rights can send new versions of software. So during this time, whenever something is released, basically it gets in Ubuntu. After these 4 months, we get in feature freeze. So at this point, only bug fix can go in or need special paperwork in order to get new release in Ubuntu. So yeah, some of the projects come from time to time asking, I just did my new release, and it's two weeks before release, can you please include it in Ubuntu? No, we can't, because, unless if it's bug fix only release, in this case we include it, but if it adds new features, we can't, because we have people working on doing some documentation work, doing screenshots and things like that, and we just don't want to do all of it again. And during these 2 months, that's also where the most of the QA is happening. So we don't want people to have to look at the upload list and every time a new package appears to go and do all the tests again. So that should give you an idea of how the Ubuntu development cycle works. Now, where can you find an Ubuntu developer? There are quite a lot of resources, and from time to time, I don't even know of the new ones appearing there and there. So for developers, the easiest way to contact them, if that's for bug report, that's Launchpad. IRC also works quite well, but just don't try to ask support questions in the development challenge. They don't like that at all. Mailing lists, we have some mailing lists for development as well. The others in that list are mainly to contact and discuss with our users. Ubuntu Brainstorm, I will speak a bit about it later, is a way to get new ideas for your software, what basically our users would like to have. The forums are also mainly used by developers. We have some people actually doing looking at the forum, getting bug reports from that, and reporting in Launchpad, because developers just don't go on the forums at all. So now let's speak a bit about Launchpad. So Launchpad is it's quite hard to describe actually. It's some kind of project management tool. I guess that's the clearest way you can put it. It basically does everything for Ubuntu, but also for tons of other projects. Launchpad is not the Ubuntu development tool. Yeah. It's used by many other projects like Inkscape and like others. So now let's see what the components of Launchpad are. So the most used one is the bugs component, bug reporting, sending bug upstream, and everything. That's we have 300,000 or so bugs reported there. So that's really the most used component. Then you have code, which provide. It's mainly using Bazaar for branch storage, but can also sync from other kind of version kernel system. So and provides some good integration with the bugs capabilities. Like you can register a branch as fixing a branch, register a branch as fixing a bug. That can be quite helpful. You also get some previewing functionalities with the code part of Launchpad. So you can say that I propose a merge. I propose a branch to fix this bug, and then developers can. Is that mine? No. And then developers can vote on that commit and say, yeah, okay, it fixed the issue, and I'm fine with that. And you can have some rules saying that, okay, after two positive votes, someone will merge the branch. So that's some of the pretty cool feature of the code part of Launchpad. Then you get the blueprints. So that's what we use during the developer summit, but also what other projects are using to register their specifications. This one is quite simple, actually. It handles dependencies from a specification can depend on another. That works quite well. But other than that, it's not so developed, because we only use it 2 weeks during a year, mainly in Ubuntu. So. That's so good. Translations is quite cool because it's a web UI to translate using gettext, basically. So you can extract your gettext template from your code, upload it to Launchpad, then get people translating it, then just ask for a new tarball to be generated and include that in your code base. That's really easy for and probably a lot easier to get more translators helping translate your project. Also, if your package is in main in Ubuntu, that only works with main at the moment. The translation will actually be extracted from the source code and uploaded directly to the translation module of Launchpad, so users can translate Ubuntu, and that will be then included in the language box. Then you get the answers module, which is some kind of support module. Where people can just ask questions, get answers, and you can, if that's a bug, convert the question to a bug. Then, some other features that are not displayed on the first page are personal package archive. So that's basically your own archive for your Debian packages. It supports all of Ubuntu. I'm not sure if it supports Debian now. Maybe it will come if it doesn't. It can also be used as a distribution manager, so that's what we use for Ubuntu, of course, but can also be used for bigger projects. If you have one big project and then 10 smaller projects that are part of this one, you can register it that way, and it's easier to handle access rights and some other stuff. Since a few months ago, it's also doing mailing lists. That's, well, it's just a front end to Mailmans, but it works really well for mailing lists. You can create a team, then add a mailing list, and people subscribing, joining the team will be subscribed to the mailing list. It also does some kind of file hosting. So if you have a project on Launchpad, you can say, okay, I do a new release, and then send some files with that. It's not, you can't send HTML page, for example, but for a release, just sending some binary or some tarball talks pretty well. So that's for the Launchpad main components. Now, when I said that Launchpad is not used only by Ubuntu, so that's an overview of some of the projects using and actually registered on Launchpad. Some projects are using all of Launchpad capabilities. Some aren't, are just using some part of Launchpad. But yeah, you can create your project on Launchpad. It takes a few minutes. It's even really easy for small personal projects, your pet projects on your free time. It works really well. Now, the debug feature in Launchpad has something that's really useful and that can be used for upstream projects getting bug reports in Ubuntu. Usually, when you get a bug report in Ubuntu, it's not so often that it's Ubuntu specific. So you can actually add, we call that a task on Launchpad, that will link the bug to your own bug tracker. So you say, okay, that bug is not an Ubuntu bug, it's upstream. And then you say, okay, I'm using the GNOME bugzilla, and enter the bug number. And Launchpad will automatically link it to the bugzilla of GNOME. And when the bug is updated in the bugzilla, it will update the Launchpad bug. So that way you still keep the bug report in Launchpad, so people won't report it and report it and report it again. And it will be closed automatically when it's fixed upstream. So that's really useful. And for some bugs that, I guess I reported one like that recently about a bug affecting all of Xul, basically. So that's basically a meta bug. It's okay, Xul is having that kind of issue. Then you add all the other packages and projects affected by it and link it to their bug trackers. So that way you get the status of all the bugs in all bug trackers in one place. So yeah, when I was saying that Ubuntu is not the only project on Launchpad, well, yeah, Ubuntu is only one project in over 11,000 projects. Now that was for Launchpad. Now let's have a look at the Ubuntu Brainstorm. So that's something we started, I guess, almost a year ago. The goal is to get the input from the user about what kind of features they would like to have in Ubuntu. We used to do that with wishlist bugs, but well, that doesn't work really well because developers don't really look at them, and people usually don't really know how to report a bug. It tends to be a bit too complicated for them. So we started Ubuntu Brainstorm. It's a website where you have different categories, you have tagging support, you can choose the project that's affected, and then submit an idea. And then, and that's quite new, only a few months ago we did that, you can add solutions to the idea. And people can then vote on solutions, saying, okay, well, yeah, I would like that idea to be fixed that way. And you also have some kind of tracking of the status. So I know that, for example, the Amarok project have two developers looking at the Ubuntu Brainstorm. And so they are looking at all the bugs filed in the Amarok category and then say add developer comments, because when you are flagged as developers, you can send developer comments that will appear above all the others. They will say, okay, that's not really, we are aware of that, but that's not a bug we don't want to fix for this reason. And then just mark it as, we won't fix it. Or say, okay, we are aware of that, but it will take some time, or we would need more clarification, and just see what you need. Okay. We should just remove this one. Yeah. So that's really useful. Of course, we have really tons and tons of ideas, and well, we have some ideas really weird, like Ubuntu should use more RAM memory. It's okay, why? Because that's some guy who wrote a very powerful computer for his Vista, and he's what? Okay, but I'm booting Ubuntu, it only use 200 of megs of RAM, but I have 4 or 8 gigs. So it's, yeah, do something. Everyone just said, we don't want that, and the score, I don't really know what it is today, but it was, yeah, really the lowest idea of all. So yeah, brainstorming, it's quite fun to look at. Of course, I guess a really good part of the ideas won't interest the actual developers, because that's, well, we have some weird ideas on that. But it's something that's worth looking at from time to time, because sometimes they really have good ideas. And recently we added the, it was from the beginning, except that user didn't notice it. We added the capability to add new pictures, to add pictures to the ideas. So now people are actually saying, okay, I would like that. And people are proposing with screenshots and mockups and everything of their ideas, and that's really cool. So that's what brainstorm. So yeah, so I have some kind of conclusion. Let's say what an upstream project could do to help and better integrate in Ubuntu and get its most stable release in Ubuntu. So something that's pretty, if you want to do a develop, if you want your Ubuntu users to be happy, looking at brainstorm can be a good starting point. Then of course, looking at the bugs. Usually we have some, we organize from time to time, I believe it's almost once a week now, Ubuntu bug days. So you can ask someone to organize a bug day, so you will just have to be around on IRC. And there will be a wiki page with all your bugs reported in Ubuntu, and then people are asked to go there and triage the bugs, see which ones can be reproduced, which ones are duplicates, and yeah, cleaning basically all the bugs on Launchpad. And for most difficult one, well, they will have a developer available on IRC to give them a hand and, well, ask the user for input. So that's a way to actually improve the software. Then, well, that's something that would be great, but won't happen. If you could have your release not done during the feature freeze, it would be really cool, because we can't include new release during this time. So if your new old shiny and everything release happens just after the feature freeze, it won't get in, and you will need to wait 6 months to get your Ubuntu users get in, because we don't update the versions after release, we just fix bug. Regarding Launchpad. Launchpad is really, really good to use. It's only issue it's still not fixed, is that it's closed source. But Canonical is going to release it, I guess it's by the end of July or something like that this year. And they are already starting to release the open source license, some of their components that you can get on the Launchpad website. So Launchpad, yeah, having at least your project registered on Launchpad is usually a good idea, so people can actually then link. You can create a project and say, I don't want to use Launchpad for translations, I don't want to use it for blueprints, I don't want to use it for bugs, but my bugs are reported there. So you don't actually use Launchpad, you just have your project registered there. And that will let the Ubuntu or for any other distribution on Launchpad, they will be able to say, this bug is upstream, and it will appear on the project page on Launchpad, and the user will be asked to report it on your bug tracker and link it. So, well, that's not so much work from the upstream project, and that helps, that helps us, because we then know what bugs are Ubuntu specific and what are upstreams, and I guess that basically helps everyone there. So, questions? Do you have a microphone somewhere?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, well, Canonical would love to add a wiki to Launchpad. The only issue is that they can't find some kind of wiki library in Python they could integrate in Launchpad. But that's, yeah, and that's also an issue with Ubuntu, because we have the Ubuntu wiki that's somehow linked to, through OpenID to the to Launchpad. And, well, that's not so good for us either. So yeah, that's something they really would like to do, but so far I haven't found an easy solution. Well, but write one themselves. Any other?
Thank you very much.